Hey guys, was geht ab? And today I will show you how you can edit your photos in the Mikutas style. Before I start with the editing part, I just want to mention that I already did a tutorial on how to take photos like Mikutas. So if you're interested in all the settings, composition and all that stuff, definitely check it out. It's absolutely worth it. Other than that, I will mention that this is a Lightroom tutorial, but if you use Camera Raw, it's not really a problem. So you can do the exact same stuff in Camera Raw, but Lightroom has some advantages over Camera Raw if it comes to presets and copying the settings from one picture to the other. So that's why I'm using Lightroom, but of course, if you want to use Camera Raw, you will be fine as well. All right, that being said, let's get started in the develop tool in Lightroom. Alright, here we are, and normally I would start with the basics and then work my way through all the other settings. But today I only want to brighten up the image a little bit before I scroll all the way down to the camera calibration. As you maybe know, I really love the camera calibration, and if you want to learn a little bit more about it, you should definitely check out my orange and teal video on my channel. Okay, so as always, I start with the blue tones. First of all, you want to drag the saturation down, which will help you to achieve this desaturated darker skin tones. Then bring the hue slider a little bit to the left, as well as the saturation slider of red and green. Depending on the skin tone of your model, you could drag the red hue slider a little bit to the right. And don't worry if the image looks a little bit faint now, we will bring some color back during the next steps. First, I want to compensate the light saturation by bringing the highlights down and brighten up the darks a little bit. As Mikutas photos always have a lot of contrast, bring the contrast all the way to the right and then add a little bit clarity as well. And as you can see, the photo already looks quite similar to the Mikutas style. Even though I want to keep this tutorial as simple as possible, I want to use the curves a little bit. All we want to do here is to add a very, very subtle faded look. To do that, set up 2 or 3 anchor points to make sure that you only affect the shadows. Then drag the anchor point in the left corner a little bit up and voila, you have your faded look. Even though the curves are one of the most amazing tools in Lightroom, I want to keep it simple and keep it like this for now and want to continue with the HSL. I mainly want to focus on the skin tones. Mikuta always looks super tanned, and to create this look, drag down the luminance of the skin tones, which are normally the orange tones. As you can see, the model instantly looks a lot more tan than before. Also, I would recommend to play a little bit around with the red tones. Sometimes it looks good to brighten them up a little bit to bring back some highlights on the skin. Moreover, Mikuta always has very bright hair. If your model doesn't have that bright hair, you can drag the yellow slider to the right to come a little bit close to this look. Other than that, let's bring down the luminance of green and brighten up the aqua and blue tones a little bit. To improve the look, you want to adjust the saturation of the single colors. Start with the yellow tones and desaturate them so that the hair looks even brighter. Furthermore, desaturate all the other colors except for the skin tones as well to make sure that there are not too much different colors in the image. Alright, we are ready at one of the last steps for today, the split toning. For this look, I would recommend to use this tool very, very subtle. Use a saturation between 3 and 10 and select your hue for the shadows and highlights. I will use a warm yellow and orange tone for the highlights and a blue magenta tone for the shadows. Alright, that's it for the look. We kept it very simple, and now let's see if we can apply this look to some other images of the shooting. To do that, open the window on the left and click on copy. Now select which settings you want to copy. Of course, you can pause the video here and copy the same settings than I do, as it normally makes sense like this. Whenever you are ready, click on copy. Then switch to the image you want to edit and click on paste. As I didn't copy the exposure and white balance settings, we need to adjust them really quick. As you can see, it only takes you a couple of seconds to achieve a very, very good looking photo. Now, of course, you could go a little bit more into detail and adjust the look a little bit more, but I will leave it like this for now. Before I end this video, I want to bring some attention to Mikutas website or blog. The website and blog looks really beautiful, there's a lot of content and it's absolutely worth it to check it out. As I already mentioned in the first video, the purpose of this video is not that you can copy her. No one will be able to take photos like she does. So instead of being stupid and just try to copy Mikuta, you should try to use the techniques I showed you and Mikuta is using to improve your own unique style. Alright guys, that's all it with the tutorial. I hope you liked it, and if so, maybe check out the other videos on my YouTube channel as well, or just hit that subscribe button. Other than that, make sure to check out my shop, because there are a lot of Lightroom presets and some of them are even for free, so you can just go ahead and download them without any email stuff or anything. Just go ahead, download them, and other than that, I will see you in the next video. Bye.